County District Attorney. We're here to announce charges in a case of Commonwealth versus Jennifer Clary. As I'm sure many of you are aware, there was a fatality, a homicide, on August 25th, 2018 here in Culleytown Borough. And it was through the collective and excellent investigative work, Culleytown Borough Police and Bucks County District Attorney's Office investigators, that we are able to at least today come partway to justice for little baby Mazakeen Curtis, a two-year-old who we allege was poisoned by his mother, Jennifer Clary, while they both resided at 501 Lovett Avenue, right here in Culleytown Borough. She has been charged with one count of criminal homicide. She was just arraigned over on Bath Road in Bristol, and she was given no bail. She's been remanded to the custody of the Bucks County Prison. Little Mazakeen, as you know, was at the very beginning of his life. You would, the slide, please. This is a picture of him. He never really had a chance to live a life. Cause of his death, as we allege it, is that he was poisoned by his mother, Jennifer Clary. He was given a fatal, poisonous dose of essentially the active ingredient that we commonly know as Vicodin. We sent his sippy cup to the lab, and the sippy cup and the contents of the sippy cup, the remains that were inside, liquid contents, did reveal the presence of Vicodin, which little Mazakeen also had in his system at a toxic level. We located an empty bottle of Vicodin, and I'm in the residence in a closed locked box, and the key was found in another location. And this is obviously after we were alerted to the fact that Mazakeen had been killed. I have an example of a bottle, but before I show you, I want you to just take a look at the screen over here. This is the actual bottle that we located, and we did some exhaustive research into Mazakeen's health history. He was not prescribed Vicodin. In fact, it's incredibly rare, if ever, that Vicodin, which we know is an opioid painkiller, would ever be prescribed for a two-year-old. Plain and simple, this was a murder, and the weapon was the pills that came from this bottle. I have here just an example of a bottle to show you that this is exactly what you would expect. It's got the child-proof cap right on it. No two-year-old could open this up. I can't open this up with brute force, and obviously you need to be able to push it and turn it to pop the lid off. Mazakeen did not do this. Jennifer Clary did it with one purpose in mind, and that was to murder her son. As to motive, we're not really sure. We can't speculate on it. But certainly what I am able to tell you is that his mother, Jennifer Clary, will be made to answer for Mazakeen's murder. I want to keep this brief. I don't have more to say, but I'll be happy to try to answer some questions if you have any.
She tried to kill herself after it happened?
We were called, the police were called to the scene, and it was evident that she had injuries to her wrists. So it was apparent that that is a reasonable inference to be drawn. What her actual intentions were, I can't say, only she would know for sure. But she was treated for injuries to her wrist, which appeared to be self-inflicted.
Do you know how long Mazakeen was dead before authorities found him? I know that he was stiff and cold, is what investigators described.
That's beyond my knowledge and expertise. Just bear with me. It was at least a number of hours that he was unfortunately had been murdered. Anybody else?
I believe it was an intentional killing.
Well, I'll put it this way. I believe that it was certainly a killing with malice, which would make it a murder. I'm imagining there will be several defenses to this, but we are alleging as we stand here now that this was a killing with malice, and whether it was premeditated or not, that will be determined at trial. But the fact that she got no bail would also suggest that there's evidence that this was an intentional premeditated killing.
Instead of cooperating with investigators, or has she continued to be cooperative?
Well, I can't comment on her level of cooperation or not. I'm not permitted to do that.
We know somehow children and youth were involved here. They are the ones who called authorities to do a wellness check. Was there a prior history of custody issues, or did she lose a child?
It's not to my knowledge. I have the same information that you have with respect to what occurred just slightly earlier that day, but I don't have any information that would go beyond that as to children and youth's involvement with this family, with Mazzucchini.
Were there previous police calls for service at that address?
I wouldn't be able to comment on that, Tom. Sorry.
She had custody of the one?
She did.
Full custody?
Yes. Full custody. Yep. Anybody else have any questions?
In this case, will you still be searching for a why? I mean, people will be asking, why would this happen? Why would she do this? Is that something that you will still search for the answer for?
Of course, knowing why a crime occurred is always helpful. We have our theories for sure, and we certainly will posit them to the jury or the fact finder as to what her motivations were. But I think, to be fair, I don't want to speculate on that just today, but we do have a pretty good idea, Deanna, as to why she may have done this. Older, not of the same age. Can you back that up to Mazzucchini there?
How much older?
I'm not sure, but they weren't living in the home. I don't think we want to disclose that at this time. That was intentionally left vague in the complaint.
Do you get how much of this vitamin was?
I don't know. I know that there's not really a therapeutic range for a two-year-old because this is never typically prescribed for a two-year-old. It is theoretically possible, but this clearly was enough to kill him. This was no accident. I don't know how many pills he ingested, though. Quite simply, it goes beyond a terrible tragedy. This was clearly a murderous act. His mother killed him, she murdered him, and now she's going to have to suffer the consequences. Anybody else doesn't have any other questions? We'll say that's it for now. Thank you all for